welcome back. So I just filmed my what's in my beach bag. I will link that down below. I'm trying to pre-film a few things just because, like I mentioned in that video, I am moving in a few days, so I kind of have a lot going on. But I did want to film a July favorites. Holy crap, it's the end of July. That's wild. This summer is like flying by, but I feel like it always does. Anyway, so I have my July favorites. I have a whole bunch of stuff here. I've been trying out stuff to kind of make it more summery. I have like a lot of combinations of products that I've been using together just to make them work. So I will be showing you guys all of that. So let's just jump in. The first thing I have is a dry shampoo. I try not to wash my hair a ton in general, and then in the summer especially, even though I get sweaty and I feel like my hair gets greasy quicker, so I've really been using dry shampoo a lot more. The one that I've really been liking is the Got2b Rockin' It Encore Fresh Dry Shampoo. This is what it looks like. It is from the drugstore, but it is amazing. It like doesn't leave any residue or anything, so I really like it like that. I feel like I don't get a lot of buildup from it, which I do get even from other higher end dry shampoos. So I've been really liking this, and I lost the cap. Sorry. The next thing that I have is the combination of foundations that I've been wearing. So I've been mixing two just because, I'll explain why. So the first one is the Tarte Maracuja Miracle Foundation. It is a 12-hour broad spectrum SPF 15 foundation. I love this stuff. It is very dark. For some reason, the shade that I have is just like perfect for my skin when I'm super, super tan. I'm not super, super tan yet. So I've been mixing that with the Revlon Nearly Naked Foundation in shade 120 Vanilla, which is just light for my skin. It's for when I'm my absolute palest, which I'm not right now either. So I've been mixing these together, and it's actually been really awesome for a few reasons. The first good thing about this combination is that it creates the perfect color for my skin. Like I was saying, it helps me match my body and also just kind of enhances the color that my skin is right now. And then also, so this one is more of like a long wearing foundation, which is, can be a little bit drying and like a little bit too mattifying. So I really like mixing it with this, which is a little bit of a creamier consistency, and they kind of create just like the perfect, it's not too matte, it's not too dewy, and it's also the right foundation shade for me right now. So the two of these together have been awesome, and I just will like mix them together in my hand and then apply them with whatever brush I'm using. I think I'm using the e.l.f. Is that e.l.f.? Yeah. E.l.f. stipple brush right now, and I will just use that to buff it in all over my face, and this combination is spectacular. The next combination that I've been loving is actually for under my eyes, and it is the MAC Pro Longwear in, what shade am I? NW20, and this Garnier Skin Renew Anti-Dark Circle Roller. So I love both of these products independently, and I've been using them kind of by themselves. And then one time I was just finishing up with my MAC Pro Longwear, and I was putting it under my eyes, and I didn't feel like I had quite enough coverage, so I used this. And the combination together is insanely amazing. This kind of like covers everything in a super full coverage. And then this one is just like brightening and lightening, and it's like a rollerball. I'm not sure if I've talked about this product before, but it's amazing. It's like a rollerball that kind of distributes concealer, and it's really cooling and just feels amazing. So using the two of these under my eyes has just been like a holy grail amazingness. I will never stop using these two together. I swear on nothing, because that's probably not true. But I really, really like these together, and especially for the summer, it's nice just to like make sure you're getting coverage, but at the same time, like I said, really like cooling, brightening, that's kind of what I'm going for. So the two of these together under my eyes have been awesome. Next thing is something that I kind of touched on in my skincare video, which I will also link down below, and that is primers. You cannot prime your skin enough during the summer. It'll just help your makeup go on super smooth and also last all day. So I have two primers here. I have an eyeshadow primer, which is the e.l.f. primer in sheer. This stuff's amazing. It's like a dollar, and it is better than Urban Decay Primer Potion or the Benefit Stay Don't Stray. In my opinion, it's a dollar and it's amazing. And what I also like about it, it kind of leaves like this sheer look, so it is kind of like nice by itself, even if you just wanted to like even out your lids and make sure they don't get oily during the day. I like this. It's amazing, and I highly recommend it. You can get it at Target or elfeyeslipspace.com. The next thing is a face primer. I talked about this in my skincare routine, so I'm not going to get too into it, but it is the Maybelline Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser, and this does help your foundation or even BB cream or really anything last for a really long time, so I recommend this a lot during the summer. I basically just added it into my skincare routine, and whenever I'm done moisturizing, I just put this on. Speaking of moisturizing, I have a moisturizer, but it is for your hands. It is the Warm Vanilla Sugar Nourishing Hand Cream. This stuff literally smells so good. It's from Bath & Body Works, and my friend actually gave it to me. I don't usually moisturize my hands, even though I know I should, and I like randomly used it one time because my hands felt really dry, and now I use this every night before I go to sleep, and it literally just like, Smells amazing. It's almost empty, and I'm going to go buy the biggest size of this that they have because it is incredible. I have the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in Fair. This is another concealer I've really been loving. I just randomly had this. I don't even remember buying it, but I really like it because it is super good coverage, and it also is like the most blendable drugstore foundation I have ever found in my whole entire life. Like, I don't know what it is, but it just blends so amazingly, gives this amazing coverage. I use the Fair one because I use it under my eyes. I can also use it a little bit as a spot cover up, but I try not to just because it's a little bit light for my skin right now. But I just love this stuff. I'm not sure if I've mentioned it before, but I highly recommend it. I think I did as like an alternative to the MAC Pro Longwear because I wouldn't say they're comparable, but I think it's kind of like similar things that they're going for. So if you are on a drugstore budget, I highly recommend this concealer. It is amazing, even if it wasn't drugstore. Like, does that make sense? Even if it was more expensive, I would probably still buy it because it's amazing. On to my last three products. The first one is a mascara. It is the L'Oreal Voluminous Million Lashes Waterproof. I don't normally love waterproof mascara. I just find it's really difficult to get off and everything, but I did try this for the summer and I really, really like it as a mascara. It's nice. And then to get it off, I basically just use my MAC Cleanse Off Oil, and in combination with my Clinique Take the Day Off eye makeup remover, it's okay. I try not to use it every day just because, like I said, I don't really like to like tug at my lashes or anything, so I'm careful about that. But as a mascara, I really like this. So if you're going to the pool or something, I definitely recommend throwing this on. Next, I have a MAC eyeshadow, and it is All That Glitters. I know this is not a new shade, but it is kind of like a rediscovered favorite for me. It's just so good for the summer. Like, it's just like this bronzy, shimmery, I don't know if you can see that on camera. Yeah, it's what I have on my lids right now. It's just like this bronzy, beautiful color. It's perfect for the summer. I really just like putting this all over my lid and then just kind of rolling with it. Obviously after I've primed my eyes, because like I just said, that is the most important thing during the summer. So I really like this shadow and it's just been really great and a huge favorite. I've been using it like every single day. The last thing is actually, I'm not sure, okay. So I'm not sure if this is an eyeshadow or what I've been using it as, because I've been using it as like a highlighter, just a highlighter. It is the Pacifica Duo 1 and that is all it says, but this is what it looks like. I've just been using this side and I've been using it as a highlighter. It comes off on your finger. It swatches as super chalky, super white. It is like, it seems horrible. I thought I was gonna hate it, but I've actually been using this as a highlight color and it just blends out into like the most beautiful, like shimmery, non-glittery. I have it on right now. I've had it on almost every single day, even though I don't wear a ton of makeup during the summer. It just totally like lightens up your whole face and just, it's amazing. I can't stress this enough. And again, I'm not really sure if this is supposed to be like an eyeshadow or what, but I really like it. I haven't really used the other side, but it's also beautiful. I mean, I've like mixed them together, but I haven't really used that by itself. It's just this gorgeous, like bronzy. The whole duo just gives you this most incredible glow. And I don't know like why I've never seen or heard of this product before, but it's freaking amazing. And it's so weird because it seems so chunky, so glittery, like so gross. But then when you blend it in, it is just like freaking gorgeous. It's also from Pacifica, which does like no animal testing, I think, yeah. Vegan, cruelty-free, formulated without FDA in color, parabens, and petroleum. So all that is good stuff, and I highly recommend this. If I had to pick like one favorite from all of these, I would definitely probably choose this one. So that is it for my favorites this month, guys. And like I said, I'm gonna be pre-filming some more videos and trying to get them up, but I am moving. So don't hate me if I'm not uploading that regularly. I will try, but moving is a pain in the ass, which I'm sure some, if not all of you know. But I will talk to you guys hopefully relatively soon. Bye.